Welcome to Choice Classic Radio, where we bring to you the greatest old-time radio shows. Like us on Facebook, subscribe to us on YouTube, and thank you for donating at choiceclassicradio.com.
What was that address again, Mary?
2400 Wallace Street. It should be in the next block, Blackie.
Want me to wait after I drop you off?
Well, that depends on what you've got to do. If it's something that might lead you into trouble, wait for me.
You know I never get into trouble, Mary. It's only the criminals I go after that get into it.
Well, that's the way it's been up till now. But every time you leave me, I start to worry.
Don't you trust me, lady?
Oh, Blackie, you know how important you are to me.
Well, I'm kind of important to me, too, Mary. Now, stop worrying. And here's that 2400 address. I'll pick you up in half an hour, if you like.
Oh, I don't know how long I'll be. You better go and I'll take a cab. But, Blackie, please.
I promise not to get hit by some gangster's bullet, if only because we have a date tonight, okay?
Sure.
I'll see you tonight. My cold ought to be better by then.
Well, I certainly hope so. Bye.
Bye.
Morning. What can I do for you?
I'm Mary Wesley. I phoned you earlier this morning.
Oh, that's right. You did. Sit down.
Thank you.
Okay. What's your problem, Miss Wesley?
First, is this as good a private detective agency as you advertise?
We're modest, Miss Wesley. We're even better than that.
Well, we'll soon find out. I have a difficult job for you.
Harder they are, better we like them. What do you want us to do?
I want you to follow someone.
Shadowing's easy, Miss Wesley. So easy we sometimes hate to take money for. Oh, but we will.
I think you'll find it rather hard to follow this person. And whatever the cost, I'll pay it. Money is no object.
And what is the object in following this man?
Well, that's not important. I just want you to follow him everywhere he goes. Now, don't let him out of your sight for 1 minute. I want you to get a detailed report on everything he does. But everything.
Can do. My man will watch him every minute. Now, just one little detail. What's the name of the guy he wants shadowed?
His name is Boston Blackie.
And now back to Dick Calmer as Boston Blackie. Enemy to those who make him an enemy. Friend to those who have no friend.
Hello, boss.
Hello, Tommy. Where you been?
Me? I've been...
No, don't tell me. I know. Gone down to the Herald building to get your newspaper off the truck again.
But I had a boss. I just had to see what Dick Dash Detective did to Peach Face, and I couldn't wait.
You'd take your sweet time about going to see your dying mother. But you can't wait for the paper to come out to see what happens to Dick Dash.
Ah, boss, sometimes I wait for the paper to be delivered.
You wait for the paper when you won't. Don't wake up till just before it's delivered. Now, look, sit down. I want to talk to you.
You want to see Dick Dash? He's going to take the fuzz off Peach Face's kid,
look,
Annie.
Look, sit down or I'll take the nose off yours. Now, we got this new stick-up racket going, and it's going great. But it can be greater.
Yeah, I know. We've been doing awful good lately, ain't we?
Yeah, but it's only the beginning. Now, listen, Tommy, I want to...
Want me to duck, boss?
No, just sit where you are. I might need you.
Oh, I get it.
Come in.
Hello, Fredericks.
Well, Boston Blackie, what do you want down here? As if it would make any difference to me.
Any other time, Fredericks, I'd resent talk like that. Now I'm taking it.
Well, what's the rover boy got roving around in his mind? You know Tommy, don't you?
Who'd want to?
Look, Blackie, maybe I...
Sit down, small stuff. I came here to see your boss, not to clip you.
Oh, is that so? Well, kid, let's start something right now.
Shut up, Tommy.
Okay.
Blackie may want something here, but I don't think it's trouble.
You're right, Fredericks. It's a job.
A job? I didn't think you worked, Blackie. Except on people like us.
Well, the time has come when I think I ought to work with people like you. That's all right. Laugh if you want, Fredericks, but I need money. That's not funny to me.
You broke, Blackie? I don't believe it.
I'll tell you how broke I am. You're in a good racket. The risk is high, but so is the take. I want in.
Oh, now, Blackie, please, aren't you being just a little corny? You don't think I'd trust you within a mile of me when I'm doing a job, do you?
I didn't expect you to, no. But you could give me a chance. Find out if you can trust me. Then if you can, let me in. I could be a big help to you.
Now, that's the first thing you said that I can believe, Blackie. I'll tell you what I'll do. You can come in on a job with us tonight.
All right.
Now, wait a minute. I'm no sucker. You're in on my terms.
I'm listening.
There may be trouble. And if there is, and if I have the slightest idea that you were responsible, I'll kill you before you can move an eyelash.
Mary, this is Blackie.
Oh, Blackie, I called your apartment 10 times since I got home and you weren't there. Now, where are you?
In a phone booth on Wheaton Street. I've just come from seeing Fredericks.
Seeing him or trying to see him?
I saw him. And he didn't see through me. Well, not completely. But he's ruined our date tonight.
Oh, I don't mind that too much as long as you got what you wanted. Only be careful, please, Blackie, for me.
I'll do my best. I'm going out with Fredericks tonight, sort of a trial. I'll be with him from 8 till midnight when we pull a job.
Well, then, I won't see you till tomorrow.
Yeah, that's the way it looks. Oh, how did you do with your end of the deal?
Oh, don't worry. A man from the Brown Detective Agency will follow you everywhere you go. He'll see everything you do.
Good. Now, all I have to do is hope that Inspector Faraday doesn't interfere. Because if I'm in the groove tonight, Fredericks and his boys will be in the bag tomorrow.
Keep moving through the bushes till you're under that first window there, Blackie.
All right, Fredericks.
Tommy and Bill drop the stuff down to us.
Yeah.
Hey, you did a good job on that block, Blackie.
Thanks. That's my new business from now on.
Yeah.
Hey, Fredericks, did you have to pick a place surrounded by bushes? Ouch! Those thorns hurt.
Yeah, you'll get a worse pain than that from this gun in your back if you cross us tonight, Blackie.
Why don't you stop that talk? I mean this because I want to get something out of it. And that's all. Oh, I'm glad we're out of those bushes, though. Which window do we stay under?
Well, the one just above us now.
Oh.
Hey, there's Bill up there. Toss the stuff down, Bill.
Okay.
Where's Tommy?
Yeah, watching the entrance of the building so Bill can work without having to be his own lookout.
Hey, down there. Catch.
I got it. Hey, what is this stuff?
Just something that's easier to steal than earn.
One guess. Money, huh?
Good guess.
Hey, Bill.
Yeah, boss?
We're ready to make a break for it. You stick up there as a lookout till we get away.
Sure, boss. I'll stay up here. Hey, boss.
Yeah?
Watchman. He's coming around the back of the building. I can see him from here. I better let him have it.
Yeah, make it snappy.
Wait a minute. Quiet up there, Bill. He'll hear you. Fredericks.
Well, Blackie, start talking.
I'll handle the watchman. Okay with you?
Okay, but do it fast.
I'm on my way. I gotta be able to tag him just before he comes around the corner of the building.
I'll wait here, Blackie. Only don't get cute. Just don't get cute.
Something awful funny's going on here.
Good night, Brent. I tagged him, Fredericks. He won't move for a while.
Better shoot him, Blackie. If he's alive, he'll know what you look like.
You're the boss, boss. Well, Fredericks, I knocked him off. We'd better get going now.
Okay, Blackie. That was nice shooting. All right, come on. That shot will bring the cops here in no time.
Believe me, I'm not waiting around to say hello to them. Let's go.
Yeah.
For some reason or other, I don't mind the thorns on these bushes as much as I did.
Maybe it's because you don't have a gun in your back now.
What does that mean?
That you're okay, Blackie. I can use you. Shooting that watchman to set you in solid.
Thanks. Hey, there's Tommy at the car. Where's Bill?
Probably still in the building. But he'll get away. If he doesn't, so what? I've got you to take his place.
I I'm awful proud of what you did last night, Blackie. I think we ought to celebrate.
Suits me. Like to go to the Carlton tonight?
You talked me into it.
We're celebrating a little early, you know, honey. I'm in the Fredericks gang, all right, but I still have to find out where their next job is so I can have Faraday there to grab them.
What would the inspector do without you? And for that matter, what would I do?
Oh, that's what I like. An interruption when the conversation is getting good. Come in.
Hello, Blackie.
Hello, Faraday, old pal. Mary and I were planning to go out to celebrate. Want to join us?
Blackie, when you and Miss Wesley go out, she's going home. And you're probably going downtown with me.
You mean there's a doubt in your mind?
Not much of a one, I'll tell you that. Blackie, you've been trying to get something on a guy named Fredericks, huh?
Don't look now, Inspector, but I've practically gotten what I want. I was on a job with him last night.
That's what I thought. You shot the watchman on that job, didn't you?
Sure, with blanks.
Blanks? Since when would a blank cartridge kill a man?
What?
That watchman was found shot to death, Blackie.
Well, listen, we...
Not that it should be any news to you.
Blackie.
Hold it, Mary. You know how wrong Faraday generally is. Inspector, for your information, I went on that job last night to get evidence you need, and I did shoot the watchman, just as I said. But I used a blank cartridge, and that's definite.
Maybe, only I don't believe it. Let me see your gun.
Sure, if you want to. I've taken the blanks out and reloaded it with real bullets.
That's all. You never had blanks in it, Blackie. Blanks don't kill people, and that watchman you shot is dead.
Are you serious?
You're the one who makes jokes, not me.
Wait a minute, Faraday. I didn't kill anybody. This was part of a plan, and I have an alibi.
Yeah.
Mary hired a detective to follow me everywhere I went. He was there when I fired at that watchman, and he must have seen that watchman get up as soon as Fredericks and I ran away.
What?
I wanted in on the Fredericks gang so I could turn them over to you. Mary hired a private detective, so if something like this happened, I'd be in the clear.
Uh-huh. A private detective from the Brown Agency, Inspector Faraday. He saw what Blackie did, and he'll prove that the watchman wasn't really shot by Blackie.
Well, let's have him prove it.
Okay, I'll call the agency right away.
I hope this guy saw what happened, Blackie.
He saw everything, Faraday. He was instructed not to let me get out of his sight. And that agency has good men.
I got a good mind not to even wait to find out.
You've got a good mind. Your mind is so dull, you could be arrested for carrying a blunt instrument. Just wait till you hear what this detective has to say.
I'll wait.
Brown Detective Agency, Brown speaking.
Mr. Brown, this is Mary Wesley.
Oh, Miss Wesley, glad you called. I've been trying to get in touch with you for hours.
Well, I haven't been home all day. Mr. Brown, I want you to speak to Inspector...
Well, Miss Wesley, I'm afraid I have to give you an unpleasant report.
Huh?
My man lost Boston Blackie's trail late this afternoon. Couldn't find a trace of him after that.
And now, back to Boston Blackie. A man named Fredericks heads a stick-up gang, and in an effort to trap him, Boston Blackie joins him in a robbery. During the robbery, Blackie shoots a watchman. A private detective was supposed to be following Blackie to testify, if necessary, that the watchman got up after the shot because Blackie used blanks. It turns out, though, the watchman is found, shot, and killed. And when it is learned that the private detective lost Blackie's trail before the robbery, Blackie has no way of proving that he didn't kill the man. As we return to our story, Faraday prepares to take Blackie to jail for murder.
Faraday, you have to listen to me.
I'll listen to you in the lineup, Blackie. And when I get you into that light in the detective bureau... I want you to talk plenty.
I like the light I'm under right now. Have you ever seen a prettier chandelier?
I've never seen a prettier mess than you're in right now.
Inspector Faraday, please, now let Blackie...
Quiet, Miss Wesley,
well,
huh?
Inspector, all Blackie needs is a little time, and then he'll find the man who killed that watchman.
You've been around Blackie so much, you're beginning to think like him.
If you'd stick around, maybe you'd start thinking, period. Give me just a few hours, and I'll clear this up for you, Faraday. I promise
you. Clear enough already, Blackie. So you're going to headquarters. And no tricks.
Why, you know I'd never pull a trick on you.
No, not much. But this time you don't get a chance. Turn around, Blackie. I want you back to me.
It's impolite.
All right, apologize to Emily Post later. Turn around, I said. This time I'm going to make sure there are no tricks.
Faraday, you're making a mistake.
Sure, sure, I know.
All right, my back is turned.
Oh, Inspector, won't you listen?
And not to you, Miss Wesley, so be quiet. Oh. All right, Blackie, take your gun out of your pocket, and then put both hands over your head.
With my gun in one hand?
Yeah, with your gun in one hand, pointing at the ceiling. You can't shoot me with your gun in that position. I can walk over and take it.
You're clever, Inspector. All right, my gun is in my hand and my hands are in the air.
And I'm coming up behind you and... Hey, the lights. Blackie, come back here. Come back. Where are you going?
The same place to light that chandelier just went, Inspector. Out.
This guy, Dick Dash, sure is great, boy. Sure is great.
What do you do all night, Tommy? Wait up for Dick Dash to come out in the morning?
He went down and got off the newspaper truck again this morning, boss. I think the guy's nuts.
Well, I'm glad you're not, Bill. Smart work after the stick-up last night. What made you get down to make sure that watchman was dead?
The sap looked up when you and Blackie ducked through the bushes, boss.
Huh?
I was still watching in the second-story window. I saw him.
Hey, boss. Dick Dash has Peach Face backed into a potato.
Shut up about Dick Dash, will you, Tommy?
All right.
So, you shot the watchman yourself, huh, Bill?
Yeah, and just in time, too. He was just getting up. I let him have it. That was all. You know, I wasn't surprised that guy was alive. Didn't trust Blackie.
Yeah, I almost didn't. I sure don't now.
Think we better get out of town?
No, not yet. Blackie will be here pretty soon. He knows the score. Knows what's happened to him, and he'll be here to make sure something happens to us. Tommy.
Huh?
Tommy, you put down those funnies and listen to me.
Oh, sure, boss.
Look, you get in this closet here.
In the closet? What for?
Insurance.
What are you talking
Blackie
about?
Blackie may be here to cause trouble. If he does, he'll be standing with his back to the closet when he starts it. I want you to come out and finish it. And him.
Oh, yeah, sure. Dick Dash did something like this once. Sure, boss. I'll listen from in here. If it gets tough, well, just leave it to me.
Leave Dick Dash out here. You can't read in the closet anyway. Bill.
Yeah?
First chance we have, let's get rid of that guy.
That comic detective of his gets on my nerves, too. Guy goes nuts waiting to find out what's going to happen the next day.
Well, he's not the only guy who's nuts about those things. I'm just getting so, well, I don't like the guy anymore.
Oh.
Yeah, Leon's, that's Blackie. If he starts something, you know what to do. Yeah. Come in.
Hello, Fredericks. Hello, Bill.
Hi.
Well, 3 out of 4 of us are here. Where's Tommy?
Out getting his funny papers.
Getting them a little late this morning, isn't he?
Yeah.
Well, I'll take care of you two before he gets here and then handle him.
What?
Don't reach for your gun, Bill.
Tough, aren't you, Blackie?
You'll find out, both of you. Okay, reach, and turn your back to me.
What's wrong, Blackie?
You know what's wrong. That watchman was found dead, and Faraday thinks I killed him.
Well, you shot him, remember? Cozy, weren't you, Blackie?
I thought so at the time. I'm a little cozier now, though. Tommy! Out of that closet.
Nobody's in the closet, Blackie.
No? Then what's the comic page of this paper lying around here for? Tommy's here, all right, and he's in there. You coming out, Tommy? Want a personal invitation? All right. Either of you guys get cute now. You won't like what happens if you do.
There's nobody in there, Blackie.
All right, Tommy, out. Well? Okay, I'll drag you out.
Okay, come on, you little fool.
I did it, boss. Just like in Dick Dash Detective. When he yanked open the door, I let him have it. Like he'll be out for an hour.
Good. It's the only place he knows about where he can find any of us. Now, beat it, both of you. I'll get in touch with you. Maybe we're out of business in this town. But after Faraday picks him up, I guarantee you, so's Boston Blackie.
Oh.
Hello, Mary. Sorry to wake you up.
Oh, Blackie, where you been?
Most of yesterday, I was unconscious on the floor of Frederick's office.
Blackie.
I'm all right now, except that I still have my cold, and most of the night I've been hiding from the police.
Oh, well, don't come up here. My apartment's being watched, and not because the police think I'm cute.
I know they think I'm cute. Oh. Well, I do have a cute bump on my jaw.
Blackie, go to see Faraday and try to explain what really happened.
No, Mary, he's got no reason to believe me yet, and I've got to be free in order to clear myself.
Well, how are you going to start?
I'm not sure yet, because I know who killed that watchman.
Yeah.
It's one of Frederick's men. Yeah. But I have no proof, and I've got to find Frederick's, if I can.
Oh, Blackie, please. Now, don't do anything foolish. If you haven't found what you want by morning, give yourself up. Oh, please. I'm scared.
Look how scared Frederick's ought to be about now. Well, I've got one lead on
Okay, number six, you're all loaded. Get rolling.
Okay.
Oh, hold number seven. You got to haul a few hundred more this time.
Hey, you.
Yeah?
Sorry to bother you when you're busy.
Hey, I know who you are. You're Boston Blackie, I mean. You're in an awful jam, Blackie.
I know I am, and I'm here to get out of it. Some guy comes here almost every morning to buy a paper off one of these trucks.
Yeah, sure does. Well, he hasn't been here this morning. Well, not yet, I mean.
Well, look, when he gets here, I want to talk to
him. Sure, Blackie. Want me to point him out to you?
No, I know what he looks like. Only it's late, and looks like he's not going to show up.
Yeah, could be. Sure would like to help you, Blackie, if I could. I'm sorry.
All right. Okay. Thanks, anyhow.
Blackie.
Yeah?
The guy you were talking about. Here he is now.
That's the guy, all right. Give me that paper and tell him to step behind this truck to get it.
Okay. Oh, but Blackie...
Give me that paper, quick.
Sure, here you are.
Now, send that guy back here and don't tell him who he's going to meet.
Okay.
Say, mister, I'll have one of those papers this morning. I got to see Dick Dash Detective before I leave town.
Oh, you're leaving town?
Yeah.
Well, there's a man behind this truck with some extra papers. He'll sell you one.
Thanks a lot. Hey, you with the papers. Give me one of those things. I gotta see...
You have to see me first, Tommy. And don't reach for a gun. Don't yell. Keep your back up against that truck.
I didn't do nothing, Blackie. I didn't hurt nobody.
That watchman was more than hurt at that holdup. He was killed. And I think you killed him.
No, I didn't kill him. It wasn't me.
Who was it, then?
I don't know.
Lucky I didn't hear you, Tommy, or you'd get another clip. Now, who killed that watchman?
Wait, Blackie, wait. Don't clip me again. It was Bill.
Yeah. That's all I wanted to know. Okay, where is he?
He left town last night. I don't know where he went.
Wait,
I don't know.
I'll find out where. He killed that watchman with his own gun?
Yeah, but yeah.
How do you know?
I heard Bill tell Fredericks.
Where's Fredericks?
I don't...
Tommy, I'm gonna...
Okay. He's living under the name of Colfax in the Walton Hotel.
That's different. Okay, Tommy. Here's your funny papers. Let's see how you like reading him in jail.
Frankie, this is the first time I've ever arrested a man and then let him go to a hotel. The things I let you get away with.
Faraday, you let me come here to the Walton, but you came with me, didn't you? I surrendered to you on that condition. But you let me do this.
Yeah, I know.
You're right. Here's 905. This is supposed to be Frederick's room.
And this is where I take a chance on letting you run out on me again, isn't it?
No, Faraday. No chandeliers.
And no more than 5 minutes, or I'm coming in there and arresting you for good.
You mean for murder, don't you?
You know what I mean.
I always do.
Very funny.
But do you? Faraday, listen at the door now. I promise you an earful.
Mm. You and your promise.
Get out of sight, Faraday.
I'm out of sight.
Well,
you just be sure to stay in that room.
Shh.
Yeah, who is it?
It's Tommy with the funny papers. Hello, Fredericks. Don't close the door. I'm coming in.
Keep you out.
Stop pushing, Fredericks. I'm in.
Yeah. What do you want?
To finish what I started in your office last night. Only this time, no closet gimmicks. This is going to be done my way.
It won't do you any good to kill me, Blackie. I could tell the police you didn't really kill that watchman. I'm the only one that knows that Bill did it. I'm your only alibi. Now, you got to keep me alive.
Do I? We'll see about that. I see you're packing. Going somewhere?
Yeah, you know I got to blow town.
Not taking much with you. It's sort of a small valise.
Well, I like to travel light.
I want to see how light.
What are you looking for in that suitcase?
Money. Though you got from the stick-ups. And here it is. Well, I'll take this and you.
Maybe you know a lot, Blackie, but it's not going to do you any good. Outside that window behind you, it's a long way down. I'm going to see that you find out personally.
Okay, Frederick.
Show you
think. I've been waiting for this.
I'll give you...
Come in, Faraday.
Okay, I heard everything. So this guy there on the floor is the guy in back of all those robberies, huh?
That's him. Name is Fredericks. That character Tommy I brought down to you works for him.
Yeah?
This guy here is the boss.
Mm-hmm.
The guy who really shot and killed the watchman is a fellow named Bill. With a little coaxing, either Fredericks or Tommy will tell you where he's hiding out.
Good. It's going to be a lot of fun coaxing him, too. You know, Blackie, maybe it takes a little longer when we work alone on a case, but we sure get results.
Want to know a way we can solve cases quicker?
Well, I sure do.
On the next case, when we work alone, I'll work alone.